Previously on Factions.
Nice, bro, nice. Boots down, boots. Enjoy the death fest. This guy's been beaking us for too long. I just set F home here. Oh, I'm going to get him with the bull. Oh, dude, I think our boy Zombie Rampage. People have been accusing Team Nudist. What are some of the things they're saying? Like, oh, the whole team is opt. They are completely wrong. D-Field's friend is here, but I have an army. Oh my God, they're slaughtering us all. Oh, I died too. Hey, what's up guys, TheCampingRusher here. Welcome back to Factions. This is a weird way to start today's video, but we are right now in our F home, and I was literally like, okay, I know I'm fighting right now. I know things are very much hectic. But about 20 seconds ago, I was gonna start this intro. There was about 50 Team Nudist members in here, and they created this F home, like this beautiful F home, and all the team was here. We were all hanging out and having a great time, and then boom, I start getting smacked around right when I'm setting up for the intro, because I wanted to intro in here. I probably saw about 15 of my guys die. Team Nudist, 15 of them died in front of me, I think. And then I start getting beat. I just get my gapple in time. And now we're here. I started this intro. Enemies that are here right now, I'm not too sure. I think I saw Angry Chicken. I saw Mustang Rex, who's our enemy. Get out of there, Stickle. Get out of there. I think he's our teammate. I barely know who's who. Oh, this guy's not us. So this kind of gets me into my next point. Hey, how you doing? Holy God, this started weird. This is my enemy, though, and I'm about to kill him. I'm about to kill him. You're done, buddy. You're done. Oh, he's done. Where'd he go? Where'd he go? Where are you? There he is. No, that's not him. Come on, where is he? Yeah, so it seems like Shark Union and who else would it have been? Probably Manifest jumped us, which, you know, of course these bases aren't going to live. It was kind of just for fun. They set the F home here and built this, I don't know, this huge thing. They all had different rooms and different chests and, you know, little designs here and there. They worked hard on it. So I was going to, you know, start in here. We had the whole team. And then we just get jumped out of nowhere. So we're in a little bit of a fight. I got to stay here with my men. Lots of my men got the death ban. And men and women, I guess, got the death ban. So it's time to give it right back to the people that jumped us, dude. Back off! This guy right here, he's an enemy, and he's going to get the death ban. Oh, he's going to get the death ban. One second, I'll give you the death ban in just a sec. Just a sec. Give me your gaps, too. Thank you, sir. All right, let's drop some stuff. How many guys we got left here? So I saw, yeah, that gets me into my next point. So Shark Union, who is Dark Union, or who was, they are now enemy to us. Napkin knows more about it than I do, but yeah, they got enemy. Apparently they were just being mouthy, and it was bound to happen eventually, I think. But yeah, so we got inside it here, and Rampage, you guys actually know Zombie Rampage. This guy's our friend too. It looks like Team Nudist ended up taking, you know, like winning this battle, it seems, which is good. I dropped my boots though, unfortunately. Let me drop some of this stuff, and we'll go clean up everybody else, and then we'll get into today's episode. As I was planning to do very peacefully until this happened. Don't block ourselves in. We need to go help our teammates, boys. Come on. Your Team Nudist members. We fight for each other. We fight for our allies, dude. We don't. If one dies, we all die. Who's left here? Who's left? Who's left? Tropical Killer X. I think he's our enemy. Yes, I recognize the other names. Team Nudist is starting to bond more and more, guys. Tons of you guys are getting involved, and we're about to slaughter. Oh, this is going to be good. Come on, little buddy. Come on, you wanted to meet Team Nudist. You came to hang out. Well, you're going to have to hang out without factions for about 30 minutes. Well, without Crimson at least for about 30 minutes. Because you, my friend, are about to get the death ban. Oh, that just looks terrible. He's trapped in there. He's trapped. Where is he? I can't even see him. There's so many of us, dude. Where is this guy? He's still alive. What is he doing? He's strong. As in, he's got a lot of health. I think he died. I really think he just died. Yep, good job, team. Good job, my friends. Team Nudist. So I guess we'll meet some of the members. We know Sean, of course. Who do we got here? We got Ninja Rex, Automan Turk, Colton Brox. I gotta remember some of these names. Catalair. This season of this faction show, guys, is all about getting you guys involved. And right now, /F-list, we have 24 members on. Before this intro started, we had about 40 on. Yes, a lot of us just died. Like 16 of us just died, but I think we slaughtered many of the people who attacked us. Well, I guess everyone. And I need to start getting you guys more involved. You know, I'm trying to raid with everybody today. We were going to do this moment looking at F home, but instead we fought off our attackers and took everyone down. So it's good seeing these guys. I can't wait for these people to build more trust. And, you know, eventually they may get in the videos. They're making that step. And that's what it's about, guys. So thank you for joining the Archon, whether you're playing on Crimson or other servers. We need allies on other servers, too. We need people in our faction. And, yeah, it's just good to see everyone. Well, hello! It's calmed down a little bit now. So, yeah, they made an F home. You know, they had all the different people involved, the roommates. Like I said, do not enter, like... They had doors. Of course, no one was really storing anything in here. I think it was more just for show, but a group of them built it together, and I don't know. Like I said, I think it's a great way to bond, great way to build trust, and just meet people and build your own community. So it's awesome, especially to see it within Team Nudist. All right. I got a really cool Daily Factions comment of the day for you. It involves basically a new idea, something I was talking about last episode, and just a good way to do it. So coming in from Dave Reese Productions. An idea for factions. Rush, every week you can choose the day. You can randomly select people for a cool thing like jelly legs or PV1, crate keys, all types and other things like that. And they would comment IGN and thing and favorite moment of the week. And then he kind of gives an example of his idea. So shout out to this guy for the initial idea. But I want to morph it into my own thing. I think... like I said, I want to give back to you guys for just viewing my videos and liking and commenting. The support on this show is like nothing I've ever had on my channel before, and I need to reward you. So, every week, what I'm going to do, and I think, I'm not certain positively, but I'm pretty certain on how I'm going to do it, like 95% sure. How it's going to work is we're going to have you guys comment, and every single week, once a week, based on all the videos, I will look through the videos, all the videos, and whichever comment is, maybe not one comment, but maybe a commenter who I see regularly, like comments on every video, like insightful things or funny jokes or, you know, just good advice or what they enjoyed about the episode, anything like that. I'm going to choose my favorite commenter slash comment from that week of factions, and I'm going to contact you, figure out your IGN. And from there, every week, I will give out something. It will most likely be like a crate key or a rank. And I'll choose what it is, just depending on the week. We'll switch it up, and that'll be my little gift back to you and kind of a more of an incentive to comment every single episode and just share your thoughts, share your feedback, get involved in the community within the comment section of this show, because that's very important to me. Comments are very important. And I think it's a good way to do it. A win-win for everybody, in my opinion. So thank you for the comment, my friend. Let's get further into today's episode. I got one more funny thing to show you guys. GG to the team there on the F home. I like it a lot. Slash home intro. I got to show you guys something. So I'm going to jump in slash fly quickly. And show you guys how much they've put into this base. This is our base right now. We are at the Team Nudist, the Nudemic base. Our base, the biggest base you've probably ever seen in Factions history, to be honest. But they did some clip art, and I find it hilarious. I don't know if you've noticed, but Napkin, I think Napkin especially, he's been obsessed with clip art lately. And, or pixel art, I guess, on the walls of raids and of our own base now. So I want you to check this out. He's got Gary again. You know he loves Gary. Then Shannon, I'm not really sure about that. Then he's got Batman. If you don't know, Napkin is a big Batman fan. It's actually really good, too. Like, good pixel art. Like, I feel like he puts more time into this pixel art than he does into, like the defenses of the base. And then he's got the troll face for people who can't raid the base. And he plans, I think he said, to do, like, 10 more as the days go on. He cracks me up. I thought I'd show you guys this. I just thought it was hilarious. So, but I actually lied, though. He puts way more time into the defenses. They've done even more upgrades, and you may or may not find out why. I told you guys factions is heating up this week. It is. From an offensive perspective and a defensive perspective, we are in a lot of trouble, but we also have a big advantage. And you guys, you won't know what's coming. This is totally new. Something very intimidating even to the team. You know Napkin, he doesn't get intimidated very easily. But we are under some high pressure right now. And I may or may not tell you this episode. I want to tell you. Keep in mind, I want to tell you and take it my own way, but the team is telling me not to just yet for defensive purposes against this base. So stick around throughout this episode and through the coming days, and I'll keep you updated. But yeah, basically what they've done is expanded the walls even more. I think the wraparound is here, right? This is the wraparound part, they call it. Yeah, right. Never mind. This thing is insane. Like, oh my god, they're going so overboard. I think the walls, well, not overboard, but overboard in a good way. I think the walls stretch all the way to our claim now. And now what they're working on is underneath, and I can jump out a fly for this, just in case, because I may get jumped. They are working on, like, trenches underneath to help to make the cannoning even longer. Because remember, no base in the cannon world is unraidable. But there are, like, you can delay them a lot. And what we're trying to do now is delay them as much as possible. So you can see here, a lot of TNT. They've been working on it down here a lot more. They finished up. These walls actually have been like this for 2 or 3 days. I just haven't gotten around to showing you. Last 2 or 3 days has been completely driven towards blowing up this crater below our base. And what it means is they have to stack a lot more sand. A lot more sand. And also, ooh, this is new actually. Today, I saw these earlier today. And there's these other walls too. And there's so many defenses that I could barely understand myself. But they've also got this set of slab walls, they call them, underneath the base. And how it works is they have to stack the sand from here. Obviously, you guys have, if you're not good at cannons yet, you've kind of seen the raids. You've seen a stack sand. We haven't had to stack it that much, but you would have to stack for our base every single wall all the way from bedrock level to where you're cannoning into. But now on this part, if you want to stack in this area, which you would have to if you raided from that side-ish, I don't really know where, you would have to take out the water, stack in between, and then take out the slabs, because water does not, or sand does not stack on these slabs. That is the purpose of them. If you get that, good for you. If you don't, I totally understand, because I'm still trying to understand, and Napkin's giving me like the full rundown. Very cool, let's just put it this way. There is so much work being put into this base. It's constant, you know, if you see Napkin of Truth online, if you see the team online, you know what they're doing. They're building this thing. So GG. And yeah, that's what I got for you. Long intro, but I guess it wasn't really an intro. Lots to talk about today. Awesome Team Nudist bonding. Awesome things happening. But behind the scenes, factions is heating up. And not fully in a good way. You'll see. My favorite person in the world, Napkin of Tea. How you doing?
What's going on?
What's going on, dude? I guess we need to talk, hey, in code or something
code,
here.
Yeah.
Guys, this is going to be a weird clip. We're going to warn you right away. This is going to be a weird clip, weird raid, and yeah, we're just going to go for it. So first off, we are raiding a sugarcane farm, basically just a sugarcane farm from the faction Good Rep. And you're probably asking why. Like, why are you guys raiding something this easy? What are you, like, first of all, what are you setting up here? Napkin's in charge of the setup here. He's got a little bit of a show for everybody, I think. So stick around. It's going to be good there. But we're going to try and say this right. But we've had these guys, good rep. They're new to the server, I guess. They're working on getting, you know, cash and building up an empire and working on just, you know, economically getting prepared for battle as their recent players. And we need to completely destroy everything. This is their only claims right now, it seems, is on this little area right here, slash FMAP. Got a pretty big claim on it. They care about it, you know, not too much to put walls on it, etc. But we want to slow them down. And what's the reasoning, Napkin? You probably say it better than me.
They're old friends.
They're old friends. And that's all we're going to say at this point, because we just can't say anything more right now, all right? Stick around. Coming days, we can reveal more. Here's what it is, though. Basically, none of the guys, including Napkin, really didn't want to say anything about it. We were almost going to do this. We need to raid this. We have to raid it, but we were almost going to do it sneakishly, pretend like it never happened, you know, still record it, but post it a bit later. Because that's one disadvantage we have as factions players is, you know, I post videos daily, so the enemy knows what's going on. But sometimes we got to bend the rules a little bit with the videos and, you know, delay or do whatever. But I convinced him. I convinced Napkin to, you know, raid this on camera and share as much as we can, but keeping ourselves safe at this point. So all I'm going to say, it is absolutely crucial that we destroy everything here, Napkin, take everything they have, and delay these guys. And delay this base. I guess that's good. I think that's good, right? Good?
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine.
Yeah. All right, but while Napkin's setting up the show, I guess, I am going to break in. We've already kind of scouted this place out. We know what's up. And, ooh, I can Ender Pearl through that instead of wasting a creeper egg. So they've got chests here. I haven't checked them out just yet, but I'm able to open them, obviously. Again, these guys are recent. They're not going to have too much stuff in here. My main point of being in here is blowing stuff up, but just kind of checking out the scenery. But Napkin, do you need me to creeper egg the chest, or are you gonna be able to TNT it?
It should be able to be TNT'd.
Yeah, there may be. We'll see how the TNT does, and I'll come back and use some creeper eggs on their items if I need to. Most of this stuff, though, my man, lots of strength twos and speed twos. They've spent some time brewing, so they expect fights. These mysterious good rep people, but they don't have too much of anything in here, so I'll wait till you come in with the cannon show, my friend. And I need a creeper egg there. Get through this area, the door. They got a couple more chests here. What do you got? Come on, give us something good. They got their sugar cane. They must be selling their sugar cane right when they get it, because they know they don't have like huge storage chests or anything that I can see, Napkin. And nothing in there. Yeah, okay, it's pretty clear. It's pretty clear chest-wise, my friend. And I guess it's up to you, because I'm just doing a final peek around this area. But guys, this sugarcane farm is massive. Napkin, give us a brief overview. What are you kind of doing over there? You're building something on a platform way up there, way in the distance. I can't even see you.
I'm going to build 4 cannons that just rapid, like, automatic shoot.
Automatic, so
try to take
4
out
machine
as much
guns
as possible.
All right.
Pretty much, yeah, I guess, yeah.
All right, dude. Well, so, a new cannon, a new show brought to you by Napkin of Truth, dude. Good to hear. Well, Napkin, we got it. We're good. We're ready to go. And
we are locked and loaded.
Locked and loaded. You got 4 cannons. The viewers still really don't know what's going on, but guys, we're raiding these guys. We need to, and this is the start, I guess. We'll leave it with that. Napkin, you ready to? So what we're gonna do here, cause there none of them are online or anything. It's easily gonna be completed. It's gonna get laggy if we do all 4 at once. If I'm standing here, cause we wanna kind of, I wanna show you guys the destruction. It's gonna look cool. So let's just do a test first of all. It's an automatic. What is? It's like the, you know, kind of a good old fashioned cannon with some adjustments that I actually understand. I like it. I'm kind of getting to understand cannons a little bit. I don't know. I can't build them like you can, but I can build, you know, I can build the simpler ones. All right.
Pretty destructive.
It's destructive. Fun. All right. Ready? So what do we need to do? Give me instructions.
You flick this one back here.
Yep.
And then by the time you make it to this one, you flick that one and that's it. Just Kay. Stand back.
And do you want to turn it off after a few shots so we stay loaded for the other ones?
Yeah, I could turn it off. Yeah.
All right, man. How many seconds in between? 2 or 3?
Just by the time you get over to the other one, you'll be good.
All right. Flicked it. Da, 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 da. Flicked it. Da, da, da. Here we go. Lock and load, baby. Let's see your work. Oh, that looks epic. Oh, that's destructive, too. Oh, God. That goes far, too, man.
Oh, it goes really far. Yeah,
oh,
I
okay.
It off just in case.
All right. You turn it off. Holy. So I'm in fly, guys. I want to give you guys a good view of this. That there won't be any fights or anything. At least I don't think so. Yeah, man, you just missed the chest, but I think you were going to make it. It just, you turned it off. All right, man. Do you want me to, I guess I'll help you start them up. I'll start with you, and
okay.
You want to do it that way?
All right, it's going to get laggy. I'll start these two, you do those two.
Yeah, I got the 2 left. All right, dude, count it in for me. All
right, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There we go.
Go, baby, go, go, baby, go. I'm going to put a little bit more delay on some of them, too. Alright, dude, I did it! I'm looking! This is gonna be cool.
Oh, yeah.
Did the middle one? Oh, it's going. Oh, she's blowing! Oh, this is epic! It's like an airstrike, dude! Oh, the TNT will randomly load. Oh, you pounded the chest! You pounded the chest!
I'm coming to look.
Nice. Yeah, I'm pretty good over here. Is that it? No, it's still coming. It's still got. We may have spent a little bit of cash on this. That napkin likes to go all out. Oh, yeah, man. I think it's done as much damage as it can, but it looks so epic, though. You took out most of the chest. A few left here. Actually, if I drop a creeper egg here, maybe able to take out the entities. Come on, baby. Blow up. There we go.
Ooh.
Let's see if I can take out the entities, too. I guess they'll despawn it either way, but that was destructive. This was a pretty big sugar cane, and we just went through it. Of course, we missed a few parts of it, but I mean, I don't know if this thing's gonna be reusable. Well, actually, what we'll do, there's the coordinates, ladies and gentlemen. If you are an ally to Team Nudist, make sure this spot isn't renewable. There we go. I like a napkin. That was a good show. Thanks to napkin. That was like a fireworks show. Oh, dude, one of the cannons imploded. Oh, two of them did.
Yeah, they usually do.
Yeah, that's all right. They did their purpose, though. Job well done. At first, I was thinking of basically tunneling this thing, but I like this idea better. It was cool. There it is. Navgi, you want to say anything else about this, or do you just want to move on to kind of the last part of today's episode? We still got something cool planned for everybody.
We could just move on.
I want to move on. All right, we're just going to move on, guys. You can, take your guesses, do whatever. But as of now, we raided these guys. We delayed them, I guess. And that's all there is. Napkin, we're heading to Factions Black. Malevolent Grapes Allies, that I still don't know the name of course. They,
Malevolent.
What is it?
Malevolent.
Yeah, Malevolent. I just say it wrong, dude. It's too hard to remember. Purpose. And they killed me once, so I'm mad at them. So, basically, they are very, very cocky about their new base. I talked to Grape, and, their cords are in Grape's description. He has made it public where this base is. So I might as well, too. There they are, if you want. Factions Black, pvp.thearchon.net. And they are very, very cocky, confident that we have no chance in the world, Napkin, of raiding this base. And I agree with them. We're screwed, dude. There's no way.
Maybe. I don't know.
Well, let's give it a look. Let's go check it out. And give the viewers a look. Give you a look. Of course, here, you probably need Ender Pearls,
dude. Look at my kids.
Come on, little guy. Come on. So, what we got to start, Napkin, and I kind of, I'm not bad at judging bases anymore. I'm actually quite good at it. I've hung out with you for probably 4 to 5 months now. So, when I come here, I kind of get in the Napkin of Truth mind, and I think, what's going on? So, first off, I haven't tested if these are source blocks, but they got, the big ocean here, and then they got kind of the walls that you made for our final base on Platinum. And... Mm-hmm. A fair bit amount of walls, but not impossible, right? Not impossible. We could spend some time, deal with the wither. And then I have boated to their base. I've tried to boat to their base, and I'll do it again. Actually, I may not do it again because I'll die. But you can make it to the interior of the base, the interior part. I don't think it loads in, though, at this point. The base is obviously this way because we're at the corner right now. But these are the outer walls, and the claim itself, you guys saw how close we were there. That wasn't part of their claim, obviously. We made that platform. But the gap, I'd probably say the gap's around 125, Napkin, how far it is.
Yeah, that's what it looked like.
Yeah, we can make it to the walls. Napkin, screw it. I gotta show the viewers how far it is. I gotta show them. I'm gonna place the boat down. Get ready. Go! We're going on a mission! Launch, rush, launch! Ooh, that was a good float. So there it is, you guys. It's already rendered in. Let's stop there. Chuck the pearl. Gapple, of course. And obviously, I'm gonna die. Let's see how close I make it, though, at least. There it is, right there. Yeah, so Napkin, I land bottom to middle-ish, is how it works. So...
Okay.
Yeah.
Not too bad.
It's not bad. It's not bad. So what is, obviously I'm going to die from that. Napkin, I guess we'll talk about it. We're definitely not raiding today, obviously, but these very cocky gentlemen over at Mavalent, and I guess Grape's involved too. That's his allies. They're very cocky. So what is our final consensus on this base publicly? How do we feel about it, you think?
It's pretty hard, I guess.
Yeah.
Something like that.
I don't think we have a chance.
Yeah, maybe not. They are gods.
Yeah.
Unraided.
Unraidable. Well, it hasn't been raided, so it's unraidable.
They were raided last season too.
They didn't get raided last season?
No, they never got raided.
Oh, damn. This is impossible, dude. Well, I guess we'll, yeah, it's over. we might as well bow down and give it to them.
Go back to Crimson?
Yeah, let's go back to Crimson, dude. It's just getting awkward here. We can't just look at it all day.
All right,
man.
Look at the walls.
All right. Yeah, well, I mean, we saw it. That's a god base.
I'm out of here.
See you, dude.
Peace.
That was maybe a little bit sarcastic, if you didn't catch on. Definitely going to be a challenging base. Nothing's impossible. Great. We'll definitely be seeing you and Mavalent very soon. Very soon. I tried to sound intimidating there, and then it just didn't. But, well, yeah, there's so much stuff going on. I can barely keep a grasp on it. But I'm kind of, I hope you guys are realizing now I'm getting the hang of this season's feel, I guess. The show was pretty crazy. There's so much going on at once, and I think it's hard for you guys to miss an episode because you got to kind of stay caught up. But if you do miss an ep or two, don't worry about it. I try and always kind of keep you guys in the loop, and even if you miss a few days, you're usually able to come back and catch back up. But, you know, if you're here all the time, you're definitely going to be knowing all the inside joke, know what's going on, and I think a lot of you know that. Lots of you guys are always here, and really appreciate it. I don't say it enough, but moving on, that ends another day today of factions. A fun one, kind of chill today, but getting ready for good things and bad things, potentially. And that's all I can say at this point. I'm sorry, I tried to, I convinced Napkin to at least reveal a little bit to you, but at this point, it is smarter for the faction, for the team. We've got some very tough competitors this season. Very tough, tougher than we've ever faced before. And, you know, competition is fun, so I'm excited. Recent 5 donators, TheArchon Server, SharpKiller86, Missile Baylor, Disco Dog, Insane Miner, and Rain City 2. Thank you for your purchases, enjoy your crate keys, and good luck on your ranks. Make sure to tune into this week of faction, some big things coming, I promise you. We're going with the golden crate key today. Come on, baby, win big. I've been winning pretty good recently, I gotta say. Boom! $100 armor kit, baby. Yeah, I really hope you all enjoyed this episode. If you did, remember to touch that like button for me. Join the rush by subscribing. Tune in tomorrow, 7 p.m. Eastern. Until then, have yourselves a beautiful day. We'll talk to y'all later. Goodbye.